Okay, we'll get started. How we'll do this is I'll give you an update first, and then after that I'll go through the whole thing all over again. Some of you might have heard it. And then after that we'll take some questions and we'll go from there. So the first update I have, so I want to make sure that everyone understands this is not a meth lab. There was not a meth lab in there. That is the first thing we want to clear up to make sure that everyone understands that this is not a meth lab. There is an explosive chemical inside the apartment, and that's what the concern is right now. And that's what caused the additional evacuation since yesterday. We did an initial evacuation, then we expanded that evacuation based on information we received. So I'll start from the beginning. What happened was yesterday at approximately 1 o'clock, Dodge County Central Dispatch received a report of an explosion at 109 Knopp Drive. That's an apartment building there. There's numerous buildings. There's 16 units in each one of those buildings. There's five buildings in that area on that property. When our officers arrived there, they have observed that a window had blown out of the top of the apartment building, and the window frame and other construction material from the building was laying out on the ground in front of the apartment. They also noticed that there was heavy structural damage to the front entrance door, and that door leads up to a stairwell. So there's a stairwell that goes up along the side of another apartment, and the actual apartment that's in question is an upper apartment. Also at that upper apartment, the patio door and some other framing around that had blown out and was leaning up against the deck. Officers then went into the scene, and when they were inside, on their way up to the stairs and in the immediate area before going up to the stairs, they noticed some structural damage to the frame of the door, the wall to the apartment down below, and they noticed on the stairwell was numerous building materials such as insulation, drywall, and other material in that hallway. Then they proceeded up to the hallway, all the damage to the ceiling. When they got up into the apartment, they noticed that the construction was damaged. Their construction material included the ceiling, again, insulation that had all been blown down, drywall, and there is structural damage to the building, including the trusses that are above the apartment. So we have structural damage to the trusses and structural damage also to the outside of the building, as the wooden frame is bowed to the building because of the explosion. So after that, we decided to evacuate. So what we did is we evacuated just that building, which is 109 Knopp Drive. After evacuating that building, we did set up a perimeter, and then some of you came and I gave you a little release on what information we had. Then we contacted numerous other agencies to determine what type of chemical we had in this apartment. So then we contacted DCI, which is Division of Criminal Investigation from the Department of Justice. We contacted ATF, Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. And we contacted the Madison Bomb Squad. And all of those then showed up onto the scene. During this time, the FBI also showed up at the scene, so now we have the FBI at the scene. So based on all these entities being there, we decided that because of this chemical, it was very sensitive and unstable chemical, that we needed to evacuate even farther. That's when we made a decision that we needed to evacuate other apartments in the area. So we then started evacuating other apartments. We set up the Watermark, which is a community center here in Beaver Dam. We made arrangements for buses, and we bused all the ones that could not drive or could not make it there. We bused them, and we also evacuated some senior citizen living apartment complex that's there. So after that, evacuation, they did some more preliminary determination, and they confirmed that we do have explosive materials in that apartment. And right now, we are working. We had a meeting last night, and we had another meeting this morning at 8:30 to decide how we're going to proceed from here forward. So we're working on a plan right now to figure out how we're going to attack this apartment. We also, when the officers were in there was one deceased male inside that apartment, and with numerous building materials on there. So logistically, we have to get that body out of there, and that's going to we're going to have to work on that in our plan. So right now, we started a plan this morning, and that is what we're working on right now, is the plan. And then we decided this morning, based on it, that we would let some of the residents come back in the area. So we went back to in-between evacuation. So, okay.
What chemical is inside the apartment that you've determined is explosive? Is it an explosive that's used in type of bomb? Do you think terrorism is involved here?
We don't know if it is at this point. That's what we're trying to determine, what that chemical is. We're not really sure. We're basing our decision off of the FBI, ATF, and the Madison Bomb Squad. We're not for sure what that is. We don't know if that's with other chemicals. We believe that we know we have some chemicals, but we don't know a specific name or type of chemicals at this time.
So there's more than one chemical?
Yes, at this time there is more than one chemical involved.
Does it appear that the person who is deceased in the apartment was involved in making a bomb in that apartment?
We don't know that for sure. It appears that way from the initial walkthrough when we initially entered the building because of the explosion with all the building materials on the near or on top of the body. So we're presuming that he is, but at this time we do not know that. And we have not identified him either at this point.
Have you found any other non-explosive bomb-making materials that would be used in building
bomb? We're not sure. We took some photographs. We had to send that to the FBI. We're not sure because we couldn't do a thorough search. At this time, the initial things that we saw were chemicals. We took photos and we forwarded that to the FBI, and we got information back that definitely those are explosive devices. And that's how they are contained, and what we believe is in that apartment is definitely explosives.
And you said devices. Does it appear that there was more than one device?
We're not sure at this point. We're trying to determine how many different devices were inside that apartment.
Do you have the identity of the young man who died?
No, we have not. We have not been able to get into that apartment as of this morning. We have not been in that apartment. That's one of the things logistically we have to plan for, is to figure out how we're going to get in there, because we need to keep all those that go in there safe because of this unstable and sensitive chemical that any type of disruption could cause an explosion.
So the body's still in there?
The body is still in there, yes, ma'am.
And who is that apartment rented to?
That I do not know.
Does that person who rented the apartment, is he known or is she known to law enforcement?
I don't know, because we're trying to do a background right at this time to determine what we know about him, and we do not believe we've had contact with him locally. We don't know if it's outside the area, but he is the person that rents there. But we do not know if that's the deceased person at this time.
How long has he rented that unit?
He's been there a couple months, we believe.
Can you identify the chemical to us? Was it Tovex or?
I cannot at this time. No, I cannot. Sorry.
And have you been able to locate the person who rented that apartment?
No, we have not been able to locate the person that rented that apartment.
So at this point, you're sort of assuming that it probably is the person who rented that apartment in there?
It's only an assumption at this time. That's correct. That's why we have not released any information about him or anything about him and his apartment or the family.
You all have a timeline of when people can return?
Okay. What the plan is we're working on the garage right now. There's some chemicals in the garage also that is of concern right now. So we are working on the garage, and then next we are going to work on the apartment. The first priority will most likely be the deceased person and then the chemicals after that to stabilize that apartment. And then we're going to start talking about when we can get people back in. We may do some of the outer perimeter. I have a list of those that we've already allowed back in, but there are some that we are not going to allow back in yet. We don't know if that'll be later today. We may be able to take people into their apartment to get some of their things.
Are you going to use a robot in trying to remove those chemicals or the bomb-making materials?
According to the bomb squad, yes, they are going to be using a robot. I have a list of all those that we were leaving back in the actual buildings. So if you live at any of these, 115, 117, 119, 123, 125, 127, and 129 Knopp, you are allowed back into your residence. Also, if you live at 222, 224, 226, and 228 East Industrial Drive, you'll be back in.
Correct.
That is the one we put the press release. I worked with the sheriff to get that one out last night.
The American Red Cross Wisconsin tweeted this morning they helped 39 people last night. Do you have any sort of confirmation on that number? Does that include those ones who were allowed back after that initial kind of wave or it was allowed back inside?
That I couldn't tell you. I guess there was a lot of families that left on their own that went with family members, so they weren't assisted by the Red Cross, and I can't tell you what those numbers are at this time.
When officers got inside, realized there was a dead body on the floor, at what point did they turn around, head back out, and haven't gone back in the apartment since then?
Once they saw the chemicals, that's when it was time for them to get out.
So that's the only sort of idea what they have, what it looks like inside. They haven't been able to even go back in the apartment since then?
They did enter one other time to make sure what they were seeing is what they saw, and they were able to take some pictures, and that's when we needed to send that out. So.
Can you say what state these chemicals were presented?
No, we don't have that. So just take a couple more for any of the residents. Any residents here that got a question? Got a resident. We'll have to, the media will get out a press release when we're going to release that information on a press release. Okay?
Later on this afternoon?
We don't know. It may be tomorrow. We have no idea at this point. So,
what is the.
And that's it. The run resident. That's it.
They told us when they told us to leave yesterday at M113 that it would be an hour to 3 hours to perhaps overnight back in May Day. Well, I left the government tax. I thought we were towards without medicine because I thought we were going to be able to go back in.
I'm sorry and I apologize for that. At this point, there's not a lot we could do. Our goal is to keep everything safe. So thank you. Thank you again.